0 hour late.
It's 4 a.m.
And it will be the very last 4 a.m. if we do not hurry.
Look, man, I think I've been polite long enough. Just what is it that's such a damn hurry here?
The end of the very world!
You woke me up for... Ugh, I'm leaving.
I am serious this time. We do not have a moment to spar.
What is it this time?
The sky. She is falling.
Yeah, bye.
Ah, no, do not leave. For if you do, you shall truly condemn us all to death.
Huh?
The meteors, they are entering the Earth's orbit as we speak.
What? Are you sure? How much time do we have?
Not much. Now put on the jetpack. I am readying the explosives in my lab.
Whoa, wait. Jetpack? Explosives? Just what exactly-
I'll explain later. We do not have the time. Just put on the jetpack now.
Aw, man. Here we go again. Are you sure this thing is gonna fly? What if it just explodes, like that magnetic saddle experiment a while back? I don't want to end up like that horse.
Monsieur Picals gave his life for the benefit of science. Now, your job will be to use the jetpack to intercept the meteors and plant them with these charges. That is, before they collide with the town below.
Okay, now, quick thing first. How do you get it up?
Oh, my friend. How is it that you get it up?
Alright, forget it. I'll just push this button right here. Whoa!
One copy of the new Metal Gear for Xbox, please!
Sorry, kid. It's only for PlayStation 3. I can give you Dark Sector. It was banned in Australia for...
You can take Dark Sector and shove it up your ass! I want Metal Gear!
Well, sorry, kid. But without a PS3, it won't do you any good.
Hey! Someone stop that kid! He's stealing a PlayStation!
Lay still, Desmond. And remember, the images you see are just three-dimensional renderings. Nothing can hurt you.
Mmm, delicious. Cool, sweet. Ah, a group of birds. The tutorial said they always indicate a place where I can do a leap of faith. Okay, here he comes. Wait until it gets close.
Oh, shit! Oh, man. Oh, man. He really fell for that one. Yeah.
That's gay.
You're gay.
Ow! What the hell was that for?
You just killed that man. Assassin!
No. Look. See my arms? When I do this, I'm a muck. I was doing this. Then you cut me. You can't cut a muck, you dumbass.
Wait. What? No. I know what I saw. You leapt down from that building and you killed that man. I saw!
Yes, I did when I was an assassin. Hello, I'm a muck now. Dumbass.
Yeah, I wasn't aware before, but yeah, you know... Now, I get it.
Oh, you think you get it now, huh? You think you get it? Is that what I'm hearing? Huh? You get it now? Huh? Okay, you got it. That's great. That's awesome. That's good for you. Think fast.
Teabag! 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 Oh! Oh God! Oh God! I need my eyes to see!
It was totally him.
Okay, so my big question is, if you put an oriental man in a really big bowl and you spin the bowl around really, really fast, does he become, like, disoriented? Huh? Disoriented? You get it? You know? Disoriented? Come on, give me a laugh here.
You suck!
What is the cost of love? Some would say no price is too high, and to live without love is to never truly live at all. A believer in this philosophy, we find a lone traveler wandering the desert in search of the black rose. The rose, as legend will tell, has the power to grant any who stumble upon it anything they desire, in return for a favor of its choosing.
Black Rose, I seek your power in return for a favor.
What is it that you wish for, land puppet?
The gods have stolen my dearest love and cast her away from me. I ask for nothing more than to be with her once again.
Complete for me a task of burden, and I will unite the lovers certain.
What shall you have me do? Name your price, and consider it paid.
To resurrect the fallen one, I require the blood of my sister, the last of our kind. Only when I feed on her precious crimson tears can I summon the power needed to raise the dead. And so she's hidden well, atop the tallest mountain in this land. Bring me her blood, and I will devour every last drop. Only then may your request be carried out.
Without another word, he turns away and begins his journey. He has traveled for weeks before finally coming to the base of the tallest mountain in the land. Exhausted, he begins his ascent up the sheer cliffs, and his descent into madness. His hands are shaky, his breathing is heavy strained, his stomach burns for nourishment, but his mind is focused, his emotions numb. Finally reaching the summit, the rose comes into view.
I know why it is you've come, meek puppet. This is the doing of my sister, the desert rose. She lies, puppet. Her power is no more, for I possess the last remnants of the gift you seek. Return to the desert and kill my sister, retrieving for me her blood so I may feed and grant you your request.
The traveler's climb down is even more difficult. Every step came with uncertainty. One of the roses had lied to him, if not both. This much had become clear, and while his next course of action remained fleeting, he would have to place his faith in the gods, and if necessary, in chance. Weeks pass, until finally the traveler returns to the desert rose.
Is that you, land puppet? Have you brought for me my coveted nourishment?
What you seek is within my possession. But answer me first, your true intentions, so that I may deliver you your ghastly request and set my mind at ease.
You think my word is that of the common whore? Blasphemy! Reveal your doubt in my power once more, and your request will be for nothing, puppet. Now relinquish my sister's blood. My appetite has been growing for nearly 1,000 moons. Yes, her blood consumes me, as I do unto it. Ah, such intoxication, reserved for the gods. What is this? Why am I so weakened? My insides are on fire. What treachery is this, puppet?
You are no rose, but a thorn by any other name. A thorn that still pains this world. And so I've removed you, in order to rid the evil you have brought to us.
What of your fallen love? What of her?
She is down one evil rose. And once I've killed your sister, she'll be restored to her former beauty. And I will find eternal rest within her once the Reaper comes beckoning. But today, the Reaper calls for you.
No!
And so, with the desert rose dead in the sand, all the hostility in the world ceased to exist. At that instant, war was never raged again, and a week later, with the death of the mountain rose, all diseases disappeared from the face of the earth. The traveler had restored his lost love to former glory, and the evil of the black rose was forever a distant memory.